spaces. What are we living for? Abandoned places. I guess we know.
It's a strange story, The Show Must Go On, because I had the title and a few words and had most of the tune and the chords and everything. And I called it The Show Must Go On. And I said to Freddie, I'm calling this The Show Must Go On right now, but do you think that's a bit too corny? And he said, no, it's not too corny at all. It's great, we'll do it. And let's write some words. So we sat down and started writing some words, and we were writing a little story about this clown who's very sad, but he paints his smile on so that he still looks happy. Another hero. At no point did I say to him, well, actually, I was writing this song about you, Freddie, you know. And he didn't ask, he didn't say, you know, who is this clown or whatever. That the unwritten thing was that we didn't discuss the lower levels. Show must go on. When he came in, he wasn't in a great state. He was finding it hard to walk, even finding it hard to sit, because he was in a lot of pain. I played him the stuff. He said, it's brilliant. I was singing, I can go for it. He said, bring me the vodka. I brought him the vodka and he pours himself a shot, knocks it down, and then he props himself up, says, another one, knocks another vodka back. He says, okay, go for it. And he went for it. And those notes came out of him. And I don't know where they came from. Those are very, very high notes, even for Freddie, who had a kind of operatic section to his voice.
My soul is painted like the wings of butterflies. Fairy tales of yesterday will grow but never die. I can fly, my friends.
And his voice has that high, wonderful edge that Freddie's voice always has, but it has a different kind of timbre underneath it. You can hear it.
I'll face it with a grin.